Joe, we're going to talk about Module 4 ng Grade 6 4th Quarter, Statistics. Lesson 1 natin will be constructing pie graph. Lesson 2 is yung interpreting pie graph. Let's start. So first, let us define what is a pie graph. Okay, so this is an example of pie graph. Second question, why to use a pie graph? Let's answer these questions. So, pie graph is used to show the relation of the parts to the whole and to each other. So, this is an example of pie graph. And the parts of it are, first, is the title. Title of the pie graph. And then, these colors here are called, ito, yung sectors. At sa sectors, yung nasa loob na nakasulat, yung mga pangalan are called labels, or sometimes we represent them using a legend. Ito, so pag yellow, mango, kasi minsan di nakasya yung mga labels sa loob, so gumagamit tayo ng legend. Okay, so tandaan, pie graph is used to show the relation of the parts to the whole and to each other. So title, labels, yung mga nakasulat sa loob. Sectors, yung mga section dun sa pie graph natin. Then, sometimes we use legend instead of labels kapag hindi kasha. Okay. Another example ng pie graph natin, ito. Ito yung title. Sectors. Yan, yung mga 50, 10, 15, 25. Mga iba't ibang kulay na yan. Legend. So, in this case, hindi tayo gumamit ng labels. Legend ang ginamit natin. Yan. So, this is a pie graph. So, English daw, 10%. Math daw, 15%. 50% daw yung may favorite subject ng math. Tapos, Spanish, 25%. Next. So, how do we construct a pie graph? Okay, so we have these four steps. Step 1, organize data. Step 2, convert each frequency into percent. Step 3, compute the number of degrees per item. Step 4, construct the pie graph. Okay, let's read this and let's try to make a pie graph out of it. Okay, in a school, there are 750 students in year 1, 420 students in year 2, 420, and 630 students in year 3. Draw a circle graph to represent the numbers of students in this group. So, first step is to organize the data. So, first step, organize the data. Yung year natin, let's make a table. Frequency, percent, and degree. Okay, let's fill out the year first. So, kailangan natin ng yung year natin ay yun, year 1. Pero tayong year 1, year 2, year 3. Then, frequency niya, sabi, there are 750 students in year 1. So, meron tayong 750. Year 2, 420. Sa year 3 natin, 630. So, let's add them together to get the total. The total is 1,800. Okay, pagandahin ko lang yung sulat ko. Wow. Next, convert each frequency into percent. How to do that? How to convert frequency into percent? Ganito lang gagawin natin. Frequency over yung total. Daan, ha? So, that will be the percent. So, yung percent natin for year 1 will be yung frequency niya 750 over yung total natin 1,800. Ah, may kulang pa pala tayo. Times 100 para diretso na. Times 100. So, 750 divided by 1,800 times 100. Okay, and that will be equal to, using your calculator, type nyo lang 750 divided by 1,800. So, lalabas dyan 0.41 o 0.42. Tapos yung sagot, times nyo sa 100. Lalabas sa sagot ay 41.666 or 41.67 na natin. So, 41.67%. Okay, next. Yung year to natin is 420 divided by 1,800 times 100. Okay, so 420. Lagay lang 420 divided by 1,800 equals, tas times natin ng 100. Sagot ay 23.33%. Next natin yung year 3, 630 divided by 1,800 times 100. So, sagot dyan ay, again, calculator, 630 divided by 1,800. So that's gonna be 0.35. Tapos times 100 natin yung sagot na yun. Talabas ay 35%. Okay, so lagay lang natin lahat. 41.67%. 23.33%. Tapos 35%. Pag inad natin to lahat, 100%. Okay, ayusin lang natin. Pwede mo rin i-round off yan. 41.7, 23.3, 35, 100. Okay? Ayun. 42%, 23, 35, 1. Tapos ang equals nila ay 100. So, compute the number of degrees per item. Now, now that we have percent, kailangan lang hanapin is yung degree. Paano ba natin mahanap yung degree? Gagawin natin yung percent. Multiply natin, ilang degree ba meron sa circle? Diba yung circle na yan? Pag meron kayong protractor, ilang degree yan bago ka makaikot? Sagot ay 360 degrees. Okay? So, gagawin din natin yan. Percent mo, multiply mo kay 360 degrees para makuha mo yung degrees niya sa circle. Okay. So, yung percent natin times 360 degrees. Okay. Una, 42% times 360. Okay. Yung 42% natin, hindi pa yan pwedeng i-multiply kasi percent pa siya. Kailangan natin i-convert into decimal. So, that's gonna be 0.42 times 360. Bakit naging 0.42? Tandaan. Kapag percent to decimal, uurong ka lang lagi ng dalawang decimal point. Okay? So, ang titignan sa natin, 1, 2. Kaya naging 0.42. At ang sagot ay, ilan? 0.42 times 360 times 360. 151.2 degrees. Lagyan na natin, 151 degree para di na malito. Round off na natin. Next, 23 degrees, ano, percent, times 360 degrees. We convert natin si 23 into decimal. So, 1, 2, andito na yung bagay natin decimal point, magiging 0.23 times 360 equals ano ba sagot? Point 23 times 360, 82.8 or 83 degrees. Next, 35% times 360 degrees, so magigitong urong ng dalawang decimal, 0.35 times 360 degrees The answer will be 0.35 times 360, 126 degrees. Okay, so tandaan yung mga degrees na yan. Ayan. So, ayos ko na dito. Ayan. Gagawin na lang natin ay i-construct natin yung pie graph natin. Okay, how to construct pie graph? Pwede kayong gumamit ng protractor. Ano ba yung protractor? Yung ganyan. Tapos merong degree. Sinusukat dito. Basta search niya protractor. Pero kung hindi, katulad ko, wala akong protractor, mag-sketch na lang ako. Start tayo dito. Let's say ito yung center. So, una, 150 degrees. Ano bang itsura ng 150 degrees? Kasi 180 yung ganito eh. So, kung 150 yan, malamang 30 degrees. Malamang ganito itsura niyan, 150 degrees. Tapos yung 84 natin, kasi ang 90, right angle. So, mga ganito siguro yung 84 degree. Tapos the rest is 120%. Okay, so this will be, tinatansya ko lang ha, kasi walang protractor eh. 150 degrees. Wow, the percent pala dito nakalagay dapat. Ah, ito yung year 1 natin. Tapos, 42%. Ito yung ating year 2. And that is 23%. Tapos, ito yung ating year 3. And that is 35%. Okay? Ayan. Okay. Ayan na siya. Wow, ganda, di ba? So, 150 degrees, 84, tapos 126. So, that's how we construct pie graph. Next, how to interpret a pie graph. So, that will be the second part of this video kasi 11 minutes na tayo eh. So, thank you for watching this video. Goodbye.